The domestic shortages will have to wait because right now Joe Biden is heading to Asia, his first visit to the continent after taking office. His schedule is packed. On the 20th of May, Biden will arrive in South Korea. He will meet the new president, Yoon Suk-yeol. 2 days later, he'll fly to Japan. On the 23rd, he will meet Prime Minister Fumio Kishida of Japan. And on the 24th, he will join the Quad leaders. India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be in Tokyo. So will Australia's Prime Minister. Now, will that be Scott Morrison or Anthony Albanese? Only time will tell. The election is slated for this weekend. Joe Biden is betting a lot on this visit, though. He was supposed to speed up America's Pacific pivot. Instead, he got bogged down in Europe. Just consider the numbers. 2 trips to Europe in his first year, 0 to Asia. So Biden will be hoping to send a message with this trip. Europe may be at war, but Washington has not forgotten about the Indo-Pacific. That's going to be his message. And the big focus is obviously China. How to contain Chinese aggression in the Indo-Pacific? That's a lot of work to do for the U.S. president. But North Korea may steal all the headlines. Pyongyang is preparing a gift to welcome Joe Biden. That gift is a nuclear missile test. U.S. officials believe Kim Jong-un will conduct a missile test while Biden is in South Korea or Japan. And if true, it would be a massive escalation. U.S. officials say they're preparing for all contingencies.
With respect to the issue of North Korea, we've said from this podium, we've said at the State Department, and we've indicated in quite clear terms that our intelligence does reflect the genuine possibility that there will be either a further missile test, including long-range missile test, or a nuclear test, or frankly both, in the days leading into, on, or after the president's trip to the region. We are preparing for all contingencies, including the possibility that such a provocation would occur while we are in Korea or in Japan.
This is why the Indo-Pacific is so complicated. North and South Korea have problems. North Korea and Japan have problems. Japan and South Korea also have problems. Do you see the issue here? Even American allies are not on the same page in the Indo-Pacific, and that's Biden's first job in South Korea. The new president is a foreign policy hawk. He's talking about hosting American missiles, maybe even joining the Quad grouping. So the anti-China sentiment is there. Biden's job is to drive home the advantage. And that involves patching things up between Japan and South Korea. Now, there's a lot of history here. Japan was a colonial power in South Korea. They colonized South Korea. And recently, that historical enmity has flared up. In 2019, Japan removed South Korea from a list of preferred trading partners. And this rift does not benefit the alliance of democracies. It benefits China. So Biden's job is try and patch things up between Seoul and Tokyo. How will he do that? Perhaps with incentives. That brings us to one major objective of Joe Biden's trip, to sell his new Indo-Pacific project. It's called the Indo-Pacific Economic Forum, or the IPEF, sort of like America's answer to Belt and Road. The IPEF will cover 7 aspects: trade facilitation, supply chain resilience, digital economy, decarbonization, clean energy, infrastructure, and workers' standards. 7 points. Now, rumor is Biden wants India to play an active role in this forum. How will India respond? Reports say India is open to the supply chain initiative, but on issues like clean energy and decarbonization, there are differences. Biden will announce the forum, this forum, in Japan. At least 6 nations are expected to join immediately: Australia, Japan, New Zealand, South Korea, the Philippines, and Singapore. They're already on board, or set to be. It's a good start. But Biden will need wider participation. He needs countries like India and Indonesia to join. And for that, he'll have to be flexible. Which brings us to Biden's last objective in Asia: set out America's leadership plan. The Indo-Pacific and Europe are vastly different in terms of culture, in terms of ambitions, in terms of strategy. America's 20th century game plan for Europe will not work in this region. Asian countries have already made that very clear. Just look at their response to Russia's war. India has refused to condemn it, so have the ASEAN member states, which means the US will have to play a different role in this region, more of a collaborator than an undisputed leader. But is Joe Biden up for it? Well, we'll find out in the next couple of days. WEON is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.